Centuries ago, when most scientists were much more religious than they are today, scientific progress occurred when conceptual filters were weakened by the insights of a few gifted individuals. Today, biases of all sorts remain, but science has checks and balances to minimize their importance. These include competitive testing, more diversity among scientists' backgrounds, and peer review. New ideas work within the system. They do not violate the fundamental structure of the scientific method. Theistic evolution, or its semantic variant called evolutionary creationism, is the belief that God works in accordance with natural processes or uses natural processes as tools to diversify life. The value of the scientific method and the existence of God are givens. Traditionally, non-scientific religious explanations were simple. People saw the world around them and explained it using articles of their respective faiths. Darwinian evolution says nothing explicitly negative about God. In fact, Darwin wrote in the concluding chapter of his famous work On the Origin of Species, quote, "I see no good reason why the views given this volume should shock the religious feelings of anyone," unquote. Even though we know surprisingly little about Darwin's personal faith, others were quick to suggest that evolution trivializes the need for God, any divine plan, and creationist explanations. But what if someone wants to engage these two philosophies? What would it look like? Could there be a reconciliation? Faith-based beliefs begin with God's existence, something that cannot or dare not be falsified. Melders who seek fusion of science and faith accept evolution as a general phenomenon, but explain the mechanism, all or in part, through divine selection. I argued earlier that a structural reconciliation as this blatantly violates science so fundamentally that what is left is no longer science, but that this approach does not inherently violate one's belief in God. The core flaw here for science is that the concept of evolution through divine selection stops dead. There is no meaningful feedback to observations and competitive testing as is needed for science to be science. When science is allowed to mediate faith, God remains the alpha and omega. In contrast, observational evidence is the alpha and the omega of science, and even then, new observations are always changing through accumulation. While robust theory is the goal of science, theory is not the ultimate omega, and there are no possible feedbacks between these competing omegas, God and observation. While fusion is often advocated as a form of reconciliation of science and faith, the sum is less than the fractured parts. So what's a wannabe melder to do? I've presented three alternatives. One, follow a God of the gaps approach and hope that these gaps don't get filled or become too trivial. Two, accept dual, coexisting realities and simply ignore any logical inconsistencies while acquiring a taste for cherries. Three, force fuse science and faith without regard for its effect on science or, ultimately, the non-trivial societal benefits that come from science. I was a melder at an earlier time in my life. My belief system had attributes of all three of these alternatives. I defined a gap for God, I acquired a taste for cherries, and I failed to understand how critical the scientific process was for science to continue functioning. Eventually, I came to ask myself, how large a gap does God need to exist? What good are scientific standards and protocols when they can be wantonly abandoned or restructured? I found that melding left me with a Frankenstein philosophy that I was increasingly uncomfortable with. I tried hard to be a melder, but I failed. Others do not. Has Adam evolved due to the selection pressures of science? Most definitely. And there are a surprising number of theistic approaches that have allowed people to reconcile good science, such as evolution, with strong faith. For me, any conflict that results from my gap approach or my dualistic approach is far less caustic than that of beliefs that include a flat denial of evolution, a one-week creation period, or an Earth history that is less than 4.5 billion years old. Such worldviews are unreasonable to a very high degree, given how well they are established by science. And they are simply unnecessary beliefs for the reason faithful.